Hey there, folks. Luke here with the Outdoor Gear Review. I hope you're all doing well. Thank you so very much for joining me for this overnight adventure. Right now, we are on the Appalachian Trail. We're in Virginia, and we're going to be on the Appalachian Trail for about 2 miles, and then we're going to get off, and we're going to take a trail known as Iron Mountain. Now, I've been past Iron Mountain. I haven't been on Iron Mountain. So once we get up there, we're going to start doing some exploring, just going with the breeze, going with the flow. We'll see where it takes us. No idea, to be honest. Now, I stopped here at this campsite, basically to take off some layers, unzip the legs of my pants here. It is not hot today. It is about 60 degrees Fahrenheit right now. Very, very pleasant, especially in the shade. But there's so much uphill coming up. I know that I'm going to get hot. I know that I'm going to get sweaty. And the truth is, I am already hot and sweaty. Whew. I've got about 3 miles into the hike already, just to get to this point. Now, when I go out backpacking specifically, I really like to wear zip-off pants. They're also known as convertible pants. That way, you can wear them when you're around your campfire and it's nice and cold. Or, if you're hiking up a mountain like I am right now, you can unzip them and get some airflow. Oh my gosh, it feels so much better. It sure feels great to be out and about in the wilderness getting some dirt time. This is exactly what my soul needs, my inner wolf. We'll howl later. Maybe. You know, it's funny. Walking through town is stressful, but as soon as I put my foot onto the trail, I become absolutely calm. There's something about leaving society behind and just going into nature that just feels right. So my friends, we've got our pack here, we're ready to go, and from here on out, I'm not gonna do much talking because I wanna get to the Iron Mountain Trail. I could stop and talk all day long and we'll go maybe 2 miles, or I could just go get this done and we could do some true exploring. Check this out, guys. My new friend. Hello, Terrapin. Man, you are cool, buddy. My friends, this is really, really awesome. I'm really glad to find a terrapin out here. It has been a long time since I have seen one of these turtles before. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and pick him up and show him off to you. But if you're out in the wild and you come across one, just leave them alone. I'm just doing this for the sake of documentation, for showing you guys just a cool aspect to nature. See here. Guess who's inside of their shell right now? This guy. You can see his foot sticking out of the side, his claws. So cool. The last time I saw one of these dudes, he's really hiding in there. You might be able to see his face. The last time I saw one of these guys, I was driving along on this old country road. And in the middle of the road, here's this slow walking turtle. So I parked, turned on the emergency flashers, got out, grabbed him, picked him up, and moved him across the road so he wouldn't get ran over. All right, I guess we'll put him down now. Goodbye, turtle. Been trying to run up this mountain. Now, I've done pretty good for a couple miles, but the mountain one, I'm tired. I can't carry this 30-pound pack and run up this mountain any further. Now, so far on my adventure, I've been talking to turtles, and I've been talking to thru-hikers. It's been a good day. Feels good to be out, really does. Stopping for a second here just to kind of give you guys a 360 so you can see basically where I'm hiking at right now. I'm up on top of a mountain. I'm basically hiking along the ridge. Whew. I'm glad to be at the top, let me tell you.
That's the way I came. Drop off. This is where I'm going. Drop off.
Now that is gorgeous, guys. Wow. We have made it to Iron Mountain Trail. Awesome. Absolutely awesome. It's actually later than I expected it to be. It's about 3 o'clock right now in the afternoon. Good hike so far. Had an interesting encounter with a hiker. Oh, maybe a quarter mile back. Older guy, probably 50s or something. But, yeah, going real slow, acting really weird. That's the second individual who I've encountered out here over the years who's just really, really odd. Yeah, I don't know. He really seemed out of it. I asked him if he was enjoying his adventure so far, and he said, like, I'm just out for a short walk. But yet he had this huge pack on, hiking poles. Yeah. Just like staring at me in a weird way, and as I walked by, I made him staring right at me. And so, you're him, I'm me. So I start to walk by, I'm like, all right, have a good time. And I see that he's staring at me, and I just stop. And I'm like, are you okay? And he's like, yes. And just continued walking off. Weird.
Iron Mountain Trail, sandy flat shelter, 4.5 miles.
We're at a crossroads here. It says that it's 2 miles to Damascus, 4 miles to Sandy Flats. That's where we're going. It sure is nice to be out backpacking with your friends, with your family. But I tell you, there's definitely a time and a place. Spiderweb Central, man. There's definitely a time and a place for some lone wolf all by your lonesome time. Huh. Maybe that's what makes people so strange. In this section of the AT. It's all the uphill. It just kind of warps their minds or something. I need to get a big stick. Ugh. These spider webs are not small. They're huge. And that's because you can tell nobody's been out here for a couple of days. The webs are way too big. But this is a very nice trail. And I have no idea where it goes. We're absolutely just exploring here. I do have a couple maps. The area, my GPS, but yeah, you know, sometimes the real fun is to just get out and go. And that's exactly what I'm doing. Spiders.
Yeah, there it is.
You know, as I'm hiking around here, guys, I think I'll stop for a minute and talk to you. Now, before I left the house this morning, I was listening to the radio, to the news, and they were talking about a missing hiker at Yosemite National Park. And they said that he had gone on a trip on the 1st. And of course, now it's past the 12th, and he is still missing. He went out by himself. His name is Timothy Nolan. I think they said he was 36 years old. They say that he is 5'4". He weighs 130 pounds, black hair. And if anybody is out in that direction, if you see the guy, let somebody know. Certainly when you go out backpacking by yourself, all by your lonesome, lone wolf style like this, there is some risk. You never know what is going to happen. There is safety in numbers. There's no doubt about that. My family worries quite a bit because I'm out so much by myself. But I tell them all, and I tell them all the time, you know, guys, this is what I love to do. This is where I belong. And I feel like what I'm doing here with the Outdoor Gear Review is important. And if I happen to die out here, if something happens to me, guess what? I'm going out the way that I want to. There's no doubt about that. If anybody is out in that area, you know, do what you can. I'll try to find this guy. We'll be right back. This trail definitely isn't as well traveled as the Appalachian. It's kind of growing over with grass here and there. Now, in a way, that is a very good thing, because that means that we are going to have less people to contend with. I love people, I love hanging out with people and talking, but when it comes to these overnight adventures, I want it to be just you and me. I definitely need to stop, I need to eat something. I am hungry. Then again, at the same time, I really want to make that push to the shelter. Right now, we are on the southeastern side of this mountain, and I would really like to eat on the western side. That way I can have some sunlight. Everything is a little bit drier, a little bit less buggy. Whoa. What the heck? Check out my arms, guys. Can you see that? My hair's standing up. As I was walking along here, I thought I heard a female's voice, like right behind me, that said hello or help or something. I mean, check that out. My hair's standing up. I mean, I thought it was somebody on a bike right behind me. Okay. Yeah, maybe that's my imagination completely, but gosh. I made my hair stand up though. Woo! So as you can see, I did not die from the bee stings. That was on the Mountain to Sea Trail, episode 2, part 2. Susan and I, we were hiking along. We were about a quarter mile away from finishing the trip, basically arriving to where we parked my vehicle. And basically, I stepped on a yellow jacket's nest. I didn't see the nest. I'm not entirely sure where the nest was at. But we had stopped to take a breather because we were going up. We were ascending about 700 feet up this mountain. So we were breathing pretty good. We stopped. And, you know, I thought something bit me on my leg. Right here. You can see that dark spot. That's where I got stung at. And so when I looked down, I thought it looked like a spider at first, but I mean, I moved it away, knocked it off so quickly. Then I felt it again on my foot and looked down, yellow jackets were all over me. So in the video, I turned it on as soon as I started running. That's what you guys saw. So basically I was running away. This is some sort of road here. You can see here, tire tracks, someone's been up here. Tire tracks this way as well. As soon as I got far enough away, calmed down, started walking slowly to the car. And the truth is, I wasn't very, very concerned. I knew exactly what it meant, and that meant going to the hospital. 10 years ago, I got stung by yellow jackets. And I have been stung my entire life. But with bee stings, with allergies, they develop over time. So you could be stung yesterday, you're fine. Get stung today, you're not fine. And basically, that's what happened. I got stung 10 years ago, and immediately I had to take off and go to the hospital because I started swelling up. I never did have any issues with breathing, which is good. I'll tell you what, this is where we're stopping to eat at. We'll finish this up in a second. I have 2.5 more miles to get to the shelter, and that's what I want to do. When I get done talking, get done eating here, I will show you the sign that I'm looking at and give you an idea of exactly where I am in conjunction to other trails. This is my food bag. Enough food for today and tonight and tomorrow. Waterproof bag, bear bag. This way I can throw it up later on tonight. Okay, so we were talking about 10 years ago I got stung and I started swelling. I started breaking out in hives. And immediately, as soon as I got stung that time, my testicles felt like they were absolutely on fire. They itched beyond belief. I just felt like they were on fire. So I stopped mowing, went inside, hopped in the tub, having no idea what was going on. And then, of course, Susan's, you know, she's concerned. And my body is just breaking out in these gigantic welts, you know? So we decided, yeah, I'm allergic. I'm having a reaction. I need to go to the doctor. So I went to the ER, and they kept me in there for like 8 hours, just giving me shot after shot after shot. Epinephrine, I believe, is one. Steroids was another. And the doctor told me that they had to give me so many shots of this stuff for the symptoms to go away that if I ever got stung, I mean, it was extremely serious, extremely important that I get to the hospital. And that goes even with an EpiPen. You got it, my friend. You're doing good.
How you doing?
Pretty good, man. I'm still kind of itching from the whole thing, but for days afterwards, my leg and my foot were absolutely swollen. So my friends, to make a long story short, I survived to hike another day, and here we are. As I was sitting here eating, a biker came through, came up from this direction, and basically went the direction that we are going to go. We are extremely close to the Virginia Creeper Trail. We're about 1 mile away. And if you wanted to go that direction, that's where you go. Where we are at is known as PVC Gap. And that's because of this gigantic piece of PVC that I'm sitting on. This spot right here is so popular to sit on that somebody actually wrote PVC Gap on the signpost over here. It really is just about the only spot really to sit down. So, like I said, this is PVC Gap, all because of that lovely piece of PVC right there. Okay, so here we are at the sign. We have Beech Grove Trail. Not familiar with that one. I am familiar with the Virginia Creeper Trail, 1 mile away. Man, this pack is super comfortable, guys. This is an absolute winner. This is the Osprey AG Anti-Gravity Pack. I did a video on it not too long ago. But it really does perform well. One negative, these hip pockets are ridiculous. They're so small that my phone just barely fits in there. And I have a very small cell phone. All right, so, well, let's keep on going. Now, as I mentioned earlier, a biker came through when we were sitting back there snacking. And I tell you, I'm glad he did, because he has taken out every single one of these spider webs. Thank you, buddy. Appreciate it. Now, for you all who are new to backpacking and hiking, peeing while you're out hiking is the best thing that you could do for your body. It's a sign that you're drinking enough water. If you're not peeing, you're not drinking enough water. Dehydration is right around the corner, and with dehydration comes muscle cramps, fatigue, headaches like you can't imagine. This trail has been extremely strenuous. And yes, I have been sweating my brains out, but I've been drinking lots of water along the way. So I have been following the yellow splash for quite a while now. We got to be getting close. You know, it's kind of funny, made me think of a story here, and this is true. Anytime that you go out backpacking, hiking with a friend, and you ask them, how much further is it? That individual will say, it's a mile, mile and a half. Hey Luke, how much further till the shelter? I don't know, mile, mile and a half, something like that. It never fails. Well guys, I stopped back there for a minute, pulled out my map, took a look at the trail here. I want to have an idea of where I'm heading exactly. And I'm definitely getting close to the shelter. We're pretty close to, oh, I believe it's called Feather Camp Ridge. We are definitely heading out deep, deep into the forest. I think it is extremely unlikely we will see anybody else tonight. All right, we're coming up here on a sign, Iron Mountain Trail, both ways, Forest Road 90, 2 miles to the left, 6 miles back to Damascus, Feather Camp Trail, Sawmill Trail. So let me go ahead and show you what we're dealing with. So this is the way that we came. Bathroom, we're gonna go this way. And there's the shelter. I tell you, I'm glad to be done because I am sweating for a reason. Woo! Looks like I had this place to myself. Awesome. It's been a long time since I've had one of those while out backpacking. And here's this shelter. Pretty nice fire area. There's all sorts of things written on this, huh? Everybody loves somebody. Time to take this pack off, rest my bones for a little bit. Woo! Let's take a look at this composition book. It says Sandy Flats Shelter on it. It says, "Welcome to the Sandy Flats. Please help us keep this area nice for everyone by packing out your trash, not leaving garbage and foil in the fire grate, and not writing on the shelter. Instead, write your thoughts in here. United States Forestry Service, Backcountry Rangers." And it looks like there was a couple people here on the 7th. We'll have to write in it as well. There is a stream right next to us, and it is definitely dank and moist here, and that means mosquitoes. So, I will probably put my pant leggings on here in just a moment, long sleeve as well. Plus, it's already beginning to get chilly. Well, the first thing that I'm going to do is get a fire going, because I am starving. I have a stove, but I don't feel like using it. And I tell you what, with this awesome shelter, all to myself, I think I'm going to camp inside of that. I'm not going to use the Snug Pack Stratosphere Bivy, which you guys voted on. I'm sure you guys understand why. Oh man, this is awesome. Out in the middle of nowhere too. Maybe you guys can see behind me this pile of brush. Somebody's drug all this over here, so I don't have to collect as much firewood as I typically would, so that's pretty nice. Now tonight, we're going the easy route, just using a plain old lighter. I'm tired. Oh man, that feels good. All right, here's the stove set up. I'm gonna boil my water right there. Oh yeah, won't take long either. Our meal for the night is a real termite meal. One of the viewers sent this in. Thank you so much, these are amazing. Some sort of beef and potato thing, some sort of stew it looks like. I went ahead and boiled some extra water so that I can have some tea with my dinner. It's starting to get a little bit too late for coffee. Unless I want to stay up all night long inside of this shelter, I guess. Now, for tonight, I do have a couple of movies on my phone this time. My son showed me how to put Amazon Prime videos on there. And that is pretty darn awesome because I have no service at all. This is a dead zone. We're just way too far out. Yeah, so I have the movie Unforgiven with Clint Eastwood, Morgan Freeman, and let's see, World War Z, the zombie flick. I haven't seen that yet, so that should be pretty interesting tonight. This might be the making for a Walking Dead episode. I'm gonna go ahead and just let the fire go to ember right now. Whenever it starts getting darker, I'll actually build it up because I have a very limited supply of wood, unless I really want to go off into the woods and scavenge around. And already it's starting to get kind of dark. So we're gonna go with what we got. We'll have a fire once it really does get nice and black and dark out. Guys, this trip is turning out just the way that I wanted it to. We're out here in the middle of nowhere, isolation, peace and quiet. There's nobody else here. Yeah, that's pretty dang awesome. Pretty dang awesome. This is a beautiful spot too. And tonight, when the sun goes down, the moon comes up, it is gonna be nice and cool too. They say the low tonight is going to be somewhere between 43 and 38. It kind of depends on where you're at. If you're in a valley, you're on top of a mountain. And we're neither one of those, actually. We're not in the lowest part of the valley. We're not at the top of the mountain either. So I would say right around 40 degrees tonight, so that's pretty chilly after a long hot summer. While I wait for everything to cool down, I might as well look for more wood. Don't want to waste this opportunity of light here, so here we go. Now, instead of letting my fire die out, I'm gonna throw some dry stuff on it, but not blow on it. Just let it sit there, let it heat up, let it start to burn, smoke. The smoke will get rid of all the bugs. And then when we need the fire, we can simply blow on it and it'll come to life. Let's go to T-Town, shall we? Just my temperature too. Lukewarm. Cheers, my friends. Cheers. Usually on Facebook, I post a picture, I ask you guys if you have any questions for me, and it does not look like that's going to happen in this episode because there is zero cell phone service. All right, I think it's time to eat now. Bon appetit, everybody. Now, with these meals, I always add more water. That way I could just drink them right from the package. Man, they are awesome. So, here we go. Oh man, that is really, really good. It has beef, potato, onions, carrots, cabbage, cream, red bell peppers. Oh man, it is great. That is great and hot. Now for this adventure, my friends, originally I was planning on doing multiple nights, and I hate to constantly be giving excuses, but it is what it is. I discussed that my mother had a hip transplant in a previous video. So, I mean, that's been taking up a lot of my time, a lot of Susan's time. She's doing well. She's getting better. And she's getting to the point now where physical therapy should start. So, yeah, things are going good. I appreciate the thoughts and positive energy and all that good stuff. For me to be able to go on this adventure here, her mother actually flew into town from Oregon. And so she has somebody taking care of her right now, so I can go out, I can have a blast with you guys, and not feel guilty about anything. We have about an hour left of light here. It's going to be getting dark pretty darn soon, especially since we're in this little makeshift valley. To be honest, I'm pretty tired. That hike was very strenuous. That's a lot of uphill. At least tomorrow, the majority of it will be downhill. Another thing that I have noticed about this trip is that all of the signs that give you directions and mileage and so on are incorrect. They make no sense whatsoever. One sign said that it was, There was one sign that we passed up on top of the mountain, and it said that we were 6.5 miles from Damascus. And there's a sign that's a little ways into the woods here that says that we're 4 miles from Damascus. So that really doesn't make any sense, does it? I love lemon ginger tea. Oh, it's so good for you, too. I also love this right here. So now that we're eating, it's time for a story. And since my grandmother has come into town to take care of my mom, this kind of brings up a story for you. I was actually kind of struggling, thinking of, like, what story am I going to tell for this trip? And I actually had some in mind, but I can't think of them now. I should have wrote it down, I guess. With my grandmother being here, I can't help but think about my German grandfather, and I've told you guys about him before in previous episodes. Once we had lived in St. Thomas and Florida and so on, we moved back here, and they would come up to visit. And anytime they would come up to visit, my grandfather would make what we would call oil slick pancakes. Those pancakes were extremely special because they would cause a number of possible side effects, or even a combination of possible side effects. One would be like you would throw up until you want to die, or you will sit on the toilet for the rest of time. Those pancakes were so full of oil. If you're making pancakes, you may put a little bit of oil in a pan so they don't stick, so you can flip them. He would have like 3 liters of oil and go through every single bit of it to make, 20 pancakes, enough to feed a family, you know? And gosh, they were incredible. Sometimes he would put blueberries in them, and that would just make it worse because, I don't know, there's something about throwing up blueberries that's not very pleasant. But, one time they came up, Grandma and Grandpa, and they brought their nephew. And, oh gosh, that was funny. We all ate the pancakes, went outside to play. And there was like a Coke can in this creek, and like the nephew, he for some reason he stuck his finger inside of the hole that you would drink out of, and went to like fling it, and it just sliced his finger real good. He was just bleeding all over the place, so he flings it, slices his finger. He starts crying, and then on his like way of like hiking out of the creek bed, he starts throwing up all over the place, just pancakes and oil all over. I tell you, Grandma, if you watch this episode, I love you, and I love your pancakes. I love Grandpa's pancakes. Your pancakes are even better, I'm sure. Nobody wants pancakes from Grandpa. Starting to chill down pretty good. I'm starting to see my breath now. Ah, this is my favorite time of year. Time where I can wear a jacket, be comfortable. Yeah, this is a pretty nice jacket, too. This is a Fjällräven jacket. And I'm sure you're thinking to yourself, oh man, Luke spent a couple hundred bucks on a Fjällräven jacket. Nope, not at all. Luke spent $45 on this Fjällräven jacket. And for 45 bucks, that's a heck of a deal because this thing is awesome. Now you guys know that I love Fjällräven. This is a Fjällräven jacket. I have Fjällräven pants on. You know, my only complaint about them is that they're so expensive. They're not quite as expensive as, say, Arc'teryx. Arc'teryx is pretty much like the top tier of price, you know? But Fjällräven's pretty close. It really just depends on what you're looking at. Sometimes their prices will surprise you because like they'll have a backpack that's 280 bucks, and that makes sense for a really good quality backpack. But then they'll have a jacket that's like $600, $700, and that makes no sense. One thing that I like to do, really, when it comes to all of my gear, 99% of it, I very rarely pay retail price. I let patience do its job, and I wait for a good deal, and that's where I get most of my gear. That's how I save a lot of money. Now, in the future, I will begin selling some of the gear that I've shown off and used in my overnight trips, in my videos, and so on. And really, what I'm selling here is just the gear that I bought. I'm not selling, you know, multiple quantities of it. I'm not opening up a store or anything like that. But I'm getting to the point now where I have too much gear. There's only so much gear a man can use, a man needs. So, yeah, I don't know how exactly I'm going to go about doing this. I will offer it on my website, pay through PayPal. I don't know if I want to ship anything overseas. That would be difficult and expensive. You know, when you get into the logistics of shipping a package overseas with the tracking, customs, and all that stuff, I don't know. I'll think about it. What do you guys think? On my webpage, I may have like a section for gear for sale, stuff that I've used that I no longer need or want, and you guys can feel free to buy it at a good discount. Absolutely. I do have a bear bag tonight, which I will throw up because this is definitely bear country out here this far. There's destined to be bears. I've seen bears on a couple mountains over in the past. So, I mean, you know they're here. Basically, what I'm doing here is taking all of my trash, putting it inside of this, and then I'm going to seal it up. And then I'm going to put it in a Ziploc bag. And then I'll put it into my bear bag. One thing that you have to remember is that bears and animals and whatnot, they can smell so many thousands upon thousands of times better than we can. So, yeah. It sure feels good to be out. Really does. Life is pretty darn good, isn't it, folks? You know, speaking of how good life is, seems like the last time that we were out here, it was about a year ago. It was after Susan's mom passed away. Almost a year. But it seems like we were talking about the state of the world, the tough times that may be coming. Times are definitely tougher for the average individual. Money doesn't go as far. It's harder to get, harder to earn. Where do we go from here? And I'm not just talking about the United States. I'm talking about all countries. My country, your country. Yeah. What is going to happen? Possible financial collapse, meteor strike or something or other. I think Planet X, Nibiru, is supposed to be coming in around Christmas. Now, what do you guys think? Is there another planet out there in our solar system that's going to be coming through and destroying us all? I've yet to see any evidence of this. I'm always interested in conspiracy theories. I hate that name. I really hate it when politicians are talking about how, oh, that's just silly conspiracy theory, whatnot. How many times have conspiracy theories turned out to be true? You know what I mean? I probably won't get my sleeping bag out until later on tonight. Let the spiders and the bugs really go away when the temperature drops. Now, speaking of the sleeping bag, I am not using the Snug Pack jungle blanket, which you guys voted on, and that's because it's too cold. It's just simply too cold for the jungle blanket. When temperatures hit about 50 degrees, that's when I stop using it. And with the temperatures going to be around 40, high 30s, that's too cold. So I have a lightweight Mammut sleeping bag. Man, a really good quality sleeping bag, too. I always look for Mammut gear, namely the sleeping bags, the jackets, really good quality. In the United States, there is a Mammut presence, but it's not very big. They don't do a very good job of really showing off their products and letting people know what's out there. I think their sleeping bags are terrific quality. They really are. So, yeah, I buy them super cheap whenever I see them. So this is one of my finds. I think I got it for 50, 60 bucks, something like that. And it's good to about 35 degrees, so that's perfect for tonight. And I've used it many, many times. Oftentimes, when you have a sleeping bag that says it's good to 30 degrees, yeah, right. That number, a lot of times, these companies just pull that, you know, out of their hat. It doesn't mean anything at all. If you get yourself a new sleeping bag, a quilt, blanket, whatever, make sure to test it out before you go on a really, really important hike. Test it out at your house. Make sure that the temperature rating is accurate for you. Trust me, I've been sorry many times. Like I said, that number that they put on those sleeping bags, there's not a very good system for measuring what the temperature rating of a sleeping bag is. It's definitely gotten better over the years, but it's still not perfect. Before you go, you know, mountaineering or something, make sure that the temperature rating is accurate for you. Before the light completely disappears, I'm going to go ahead and just throw up my bear bag. Got all my garbage, all my food, all that good stuff inside of this. This is an Outdoor Research dry bag. It really does work well for a bear bag. One thing that I like about it is that it has a ring on it, so you can clip a carabiner to it. Now what I have here is just some very strong bank line, and lots of it. This stuff's super duper lightweight, very strong, much, much, much lighter than paracord, and it works great for bear lines. All I have to do really is attach some of these pieces together, make a long enough line. On one end of each one of these strands, I have a slip knot that I put into each one. So I can just go from slip knot, slip knot, slip knot. Having the slip knots done like that makes it very, very simple to connect all these together and also to break it down in the morning. Just little things that you learn when you spend enough time outside. Anytime that you're sitting in bed, watching TV or something like that, you should have a guide on how to do knots opened up. And that way, you can learn something while you're watching TV. So check this out. Carabiner onto our bear line. And then we can attach that right to our bear bag and we're good to go. All right, well, sun's going down, starting to get dark. Pretty much have camp and everything taken care of. Bear bags up, sleeping pad inflated, sleeping bag out, and I'll show you guys all that stuff in the morning. Working around camp, processing some wood, kind of getting everything ready for the night, and we're in pretty good shape. It's definitely starting to cool down. It's getting cold, and it feels amazing. It really does. Here in the next 15 minutes, we'll get the fire going again, chill around the fire for a little bit, and then call it a night because I am beat. I'm tired. As mentioned, I do have a couple movies to watch, and I think I will start off with Unforgiven with Clint Eastwood. That is a great movie. If you guys haven't seen that, it's a Western. It is absolutely awesome. It is definitely worth a watch if you like that sort of genre of movies. You know, I'm thinking about this shelter here. You know, it's been a long time since I've slept in a shelter, and I wonder how many rodents I will have running over me, chewing on my sleeping bag and all that stuff. That's typically how it goes when you sleep in a shelter. And that's just something that you get used to over time. Whew. So my friends, I guess I'm going to kick back and relax around the fire just a little bit. It doesn't have much life left to it. And then, bedtime. Oh yeah. Alright guys, I am now in my shelter, about ready to turn in, taking off my damp, wet socks, gonna let them air out and dry out tonight, plus that will keep me warmer with some fresh socks. Yeah, the fire's pretty much out, smoking still, and that's alright, that'll just keep all the bugs and everything away. I'm using a bag full of clothes as my pillow tonight. Oh man, that is awesome. Alright guys, well, I'm gonna kick back. I'm gonna start a movie. It's already pretty late, it's about 10:30, 11 o'clock. And I am beat. It was a good day, everybody. I want to thank you all so very much for joining me for this adventure. It really has been an adventure, just exploring out in the middle of nowhere, not entirely sure where we're at. But doing it safely at the same time, of course. But, guys, I will see you in the morning, and another adventure awaits, I'm sure. See you guys. Oh, man. Oh, man. Good morning, guys. Golly, it is cold this morning. I was nice and warm until maybe, I don't know, a couple of hours ago. The bottom just fell out. That clear sky allowed it just to get cold. I'd say it's in the 30s right now. I mean, it really is cold. But luckily, inside of my sleeping bag, I'm just fine. Pretty comfortable, really, all night long. No complaints. Slept pretty good. Every once in a while, I'd wake up hearing something, you know, break in the forest or some sort of weird critter. Who knows? But yeah. Oh, man. Man, I tell you, I really want some coffee, but I don't want to get out of this sleeping bag. I don't want to get out until it reaches 60 degrees. Yeah. Man, oh man. Oh man. It's 7:52. I'm going to get out at 8 o'clock. And I'll bring you back then. Alright guys, well first things first, it's coffee time, so that means we're going to have to get the bear bag down and find some water. Luckily, we have multiple sources of water very, very close, so let's go ahead and grab the bear bag now. This shelter is pretty awesome, guys. I had a good time just landing in here, reading all the stuff that's written all over the walls. Apparently, Virginia Tech sucks. That's so important to somebody that they had to write that on the walls. That's funny. There's a number on the wall, pretty much offering a good time for $40 or less. That's pretty awesome. I can't imagine what would actually come to you if you called that number, considering the fact that we're out in the backcountry. What exactly would be coming our way? This is a really nice spot, guys. This really is. I'd like to come back to this, like when they're calling for a winter storm. That would be all right. So the plan is basically to have a snack, have some coffee, and then it's time to get ourselves out of here. Yep, sadly, have to return to the real world, you know what I mean? Gah. I think it's frozen.
Josh apparently loves guys. The Andy B was here. People love guar for some reason. Oh yeah.
So my friends, this is my sleep setup right here. Just a simple air mattress and the Mammut sleeping bag.
So my friends, our gear is packed up. We're pretty much ready to go. Now, since I have that nice bathroom, I think I'm going to go use it. Probably the nicest toilet that I've used outside in a long time. When I bring you guys back, we'll be on the trail. I'll tell you what, my friends, I am glad that I have a good memory because we've taken a lot of different trails to make it to this point. I mean, seriously. If you don't have a good memory, make sure to write it down.
All right, guys, I've gotten hot. That did not take long.
Woo.
Gosh, it feels good. It's that perfect balance between being cold and being warm, all mixed together. I love the sounds of the forest. It's beautiful.
Okay, here we go. As we're hiking along here, something came to mind. Of course, when you go out backpacking, it gives you tons of time to think about things. And so one thing that I've been thinking about a lot lately is my cousin. He's been very troubled for the last 10 years or so. And, you know, he spent some time in prison, and it all involves around drugs, meth, pills, all sorts of terrible crap that he will probably be addicted to forever. Well, just recently, he got out of prison for almost a year, maybe. But he's back in again, probably going to be sentenced for a long time. Stealing, selling, who knows what. I'm not entirely sure. I'm just thinking about that. And for the younger viewers out there who are watching this channel, my advice to you is to never, ever try that stuff. But you know, when you're at a party and one of your friends offers you whatever, you don't have to be a jerk about it. All you have to say is, man, I appreciate it, but I'm good. No thanks. That is how you handle that situation. I've been there so many times. And there's a way to do it without offending someone, making them mad, losing a friend. I'm just thinking here, gosh, I feel bad for my cousin. He's really messed up his life. And he doesn't really like me either at the moment. On Facebook, I noticed that my daughter was friends with him. And I already know the type of guy he is. He's not a bad guy. But when you're hooked on that crap, you will do anything. And so I made her delete him. And then, of course, he realized that, asked her why. And then I hopped in, and I was like, listen. And I said, you know, buddy, I love you very, very much. And I always have your back. But you are not a good influence. And my kids do not need to be friends with you on Facebook. Until you get your life cleared up and straight, they will have nothing to do with you. You know, especially to the younger generation, you feel so much better when you feel healthy, when you feel good. All right, well, I'll get off my soapbox for a little bit. Stay healthy, my friends, stay healthy. Make good choices. We are making awesome progress. We're really just trucking through this. It's all downhill too. Hiking downhill or running downhill makes you feel like the best athlete ever. That's how I feel right now. Oh man, I'm really going through this quick. I'm in such good shape. Holy crap, there's a bear, guys.
Yeah, get out of here.
All I know is it's time to get out of here. That's not necessarily a cub, but that's not a fully grown bear either. I told ya, they're around here. All right, turn the camera off so I can focus and listen. Just in case, I gotta act. Okay, well, we're a pretty good distance away now. Far enough away to start filming again. That was cool. As I was walking along, I was hearing sticks break, twigs break,
way up in that tree. And it got to the point where I could see this furry black butt. And as I was walking along, it came scurrying down as fast as it could. I screamed at it. It hauled butt, took off. Oh yeah. That's what adventuring is all about. So my friends, we're here at PVC Gap again. Nice sitting spot. And we have a decision to make. Do we head back the way we came? Or do we go over here, head to the Creeper Trail, and walk down that? Now, it's about a mile away, it says. And the question is, when we get onto the Creeper Trail, how far away are we from Damascus? It's all downhill, and that's good, but we could be really, really far. It just depends on which mountains that we've gone over and where exactly we're coming out at, and I won't know that until we actually get out on the trail. So, you know what? Let's do it. Let's head to the Virginia Creeper Trail. Why not? We got this. All right, guys, well, this is interesting. I've been going downhill for about an hour and a half, 2 hours, something like that. And if you guys remember a year ago when we came out here and we basically just camped out next to this old trail, kind of uncertain where we were at, but it was on the Appalachian Trail. I think we're actually there again. I think this is the AT over here. We went down this direction and camped down here.
AT North. That will take you to the Virginia Creeper, and like right at the top too. I'm not sure if I really want to do that. Or we could take the AT south. That's the direction that we need to go.
I'll tell you what, that's probably the best idea, because if we go that way, gosh, we'll have, I don't know, 12 miles to do. I love the idea, but for the sake of the day getting on, yeah. Too long. Yeah, that's cool. We're back here again. All right. Well, let's keep on going then. As I was hiking along, I was thinking, you know, this comes out on the Virginia Creeper Trail. Where could that be at? Because I'm pretty familiar with it. And I was thinking, right at the top, there's that one trail that branches off. That has to be it. And apparently I'm right.
Yes.
Awesome. Well, folks, we have made really, really good progress because we are now back to Iron Mountain Trail. All right. I'm not even sure if I can figure out how many miles I've hiked on this trip. I've taken so many different trails. Yeah, I don't know. That'd be interesting. I'll try to do it.
Gosh, look at that view. Look at that sky. Woo. How's your adventures going, buddy?
You know, it's another adventure, another day in paradise.
Dang right.
How is she?
Oh, she's gorgeous.
Yeah, isn't she though?
Wow. Wow, she's big.
Back on the trail again after stopping for about an hour or so, talking to a guy named Bruce, real friendly guy. That was a good time. We sat there, watched that indigo racer, that snake, for a long time. Beautiful, about 5 foot long. Well, we're definitely getting close to town now. Oh, another mile or so. It's a mile, mile and a half. I'm gonna go straight into town and buy the biggest cheeseburger I could possibly find. That sounds pretty darn good, don't it? Well, my friends, I wanna thank you all very much for joining me on this adventure. It truly has been an awesome adventure. Strength and honor to you all. I will see you guys around. Take care. Be well.